So let's start by the beginning, which is typically a good place to start, right? So what we're going to do in this video is we're going to learn how to create a very simple WebSocket client in Grasshopper so that we can connect to an Echo server, like the ones that we have used before, or the one that we have been using in the previous videos, the one that we wrote in Glitch. So in order to do that, we're going to, as opposed to writing things from scratch as usual, we may just use somebody else's library to do that. And it turns out that there is a very nice nifty library out there called Benges, which was written by a friend of mine, actually, Behrouz Tahansandeh. I probably did not pronounce that correctly. Iranian. He did his master's at the ITEC, and he has written this wonderful plugin that allows us to do a lot of, for example, HTTP communication, connecting to a Wii remote controller, do some curves operation with Mucarnas, and then it has a WebSocket client, sender, et cetera, which is the functionality we're going to use. Also, I shall mention the project is open source, and I'm very happy about open source projects because it's a really nice way of figuring out how someone wrote a Grasshopper plugin and then how we can do, for example, custom WebSocket implementations in C Sharp and for Grasshopper in particular. So big thumbs up to Behrouz. Thank you very much for this contribution. And we're going to put it to some use today in this video. So we're going to try to connect to the simple WebSocket server that we have been using in the previous examples, which, if you remember, had a URL of this kind. So if I click on show the app, whatever, it's going to send me to this address. So I'm going to paste this here. This is going to be the URL that I want to go to. And I need to replace HTTP as the transport to WebSocket. Okay, so this is the address of the WebSocket server we have been using, which, if you remember, is just a server that whatever is sent to by one client is broadcast to all the clients that are connected to that server. All right, and we have been using it to exchange mostly XY normalized coordinates. So what I'm going to do now is very simple. I'm just going to drop here a WebSocket client start from the Benges library. And let me please add some bifocals here so that non-icon people can follow this tutorial as well. And I've also bypassed, I haven't explained how to install Benges, but that's very, you can find that in the documentation of the plugin. So you can download the product from Food4Rhino or from the GitHub repo. It's very easy to do. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to say, the client needs the URL, which is going to be this one here. And you can see that it has an initial message that it sends to the server right away, which in this case is Hello World. And you can see that as soon as I connected, my server gave me the notification that someone just connected and that received this message from the client. So, ta-da, it's already working. It was just as simple as dropping one component. How awesome is that, right? And we also get here a notification that this is working. I have here a Boolean option to reset these values. So, for example, I'm going to write here a Boolean toggle. Do I want to reset the server? Yes, let's reset the server and then start it over again. All right. And also, I'm going to override this initial message because I don't want to send anything upon connection. All right. Or if you will, actually, I can play with this a little bit because I can type here, what's up? And as soon as I change that, that's going to be sent to the server, I believe. No, it's not. The way we're going to do that is, sorry, I'm going to override this because I don't want an initial message. What I want is to write here a server. Whoa, look at this. Somebody from Japan, probably Arasto, if I may, who is, because I'm recording these tutorials on a live stream with a lot of people from the community live with me. So somebody just connected to the server and is sending these messages. I believe it's Arasto. Thanks a lot for that. So let me write something that actually listens to these things. First of all, I'm going to implement a sender here, which is going to be useful to, for example, connect here a message and say, hello from Grasshopper. And then as I click that, You see that I get this message here. I also did get the message double click to edit the panel. Can I zoom in here? Yes. So for example, if I try to edit this hello from Grasshopper again, as I change this, this is going to be sent to the server. You see hello from Grasshopper again. Hello to the PCamp community. And then I'm going to send that, and this gets sent to the server as well. Okay, so my WebSocket client is effectively connected to the server and is sending any message that I see. So if I actually, for example, if I connect a slider with values from 0 to 10, you're going to see that as soon as I move my slider around, you see, it's going to send all those messages one by one to the server. You see all the numbers. So this can get actually very data intensive very soon. All right. And I don't know why this is not. Let me just clear this. Can you see how pop, 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 pop. You see how as I move this, I'm sending all this stuff to the server. Okay, that's going well. Now, another thing that I may want to do is I may want to listen to the server, because remember that the server is bouncing back all the data to everyone. So what I want to do is I want to create a receiver. And then this receiver is going to send me, it's going to give me messages that are going to be bounced. Okay, so for example, here I'm going to be receiving anything that is sent through the WebSocket server. So can you see here? Arasto, can you send us a message so that we can see it up there in this panel here? So you see that as I'm changing this, I am receiving data from the server, okay? I didn't do that. So some people from the community who are watching this video right now are sending the hello world. Arasto, can you send us like something from Japan? And a way also to know that we are receiving lots of messages as this is happening is by connecting a recorder. So if I connect a cool message from Japan, so that was Arasto. Let me properly respond to this. Thank you, Arasto. And hopefully he will get this message in Japan, right? Yeah, thank you, Arasto. So a way to know that this is happening is that we are receiving a lot of data is by plugging in a recorder so that we can actually record all the data that is coming through this client. So as I do this, you see that I am recording all this data, and if other people watching this stream may send some information, this will probably get added also to the list that I am receiving here. Okay, wonderful. So that was just as easy as slightly typo. So that was as easy as it goes. Now, what we can also receive, remember, is connections from the other applications that we have written so far. So for example, if I go to the example where I had the ball that was changing in coordinates, you can see how I am receiving the XY coordinates of this object in 3D space. Okay, because this sketch is connecting to the same server and is broadcasting data to all the clients. So in the next video, what I would like to do is I would like to be able to take this data, the XY data, parse it, and then use it to move some geometry on my Grasshopper, on my Rhino sketch, synchronized with the request that I'm getting from the P5 sketch, for example. So let's do that on the next video.